Greetings, Guardians. My name is Byfair. Welcome back to my guide to the Crucible. In this episode, we're going to be talking about guns. I know, sounds like a very generic topic, but some people will genuinely ask me this. They'll present a weapon towards me, and I'll be able to tell them whether it's good or not, and some people question why I can do that. Now, this is not me calling people out, this is me genuinely telling you why I can do that. It's from experience. And it's really from experience because of the fact that I have taken a look at the prime weapons in Destiny in terms of what works in the meta and what doesn't, and I can just define what's good on a weapon now. Having knowledge like this means that I have some small advantage in terms of play. I can counter some playstyles if they're being used, but at the same time, it's just nice to have this knowledge for yourself. To give you an example, at one point I was talking to a friend who did a lot of Trials of Osiris, but for some reason always found themselves on the worst end of the scoreboard. You know, they'd be going 3-3, or 2-3, or 1-3, or maybe 4-3 if they were lucky, and they'd never be able to get to the weapon or the armor. So I really wanted to go ahead and just point out some things they were doing wrong. So first of all, ignore the attack stat on weapons in normal Crucible, right? In Trials, of course, it's going to matter, and in which case you should probably ignore what I'm about to say. But if you're in normal Crucible, just because Atheon's Epilogue has a higher level of attack does not mean that it is a full-over better weapon than the Kvashtov. I would take the Kvashtov over the Atheon's Epilogue any day in Crucible. Like, in a heartbeat. And that's not saying anything about anything I would take over the Atheon's Epilogue on a normal day, right? Like, there are just some weapons that are straight up better. Now, if you're going to ignore attack stats altogether and think of what weapons work, some weapon types genuinely are just better built for Crucible, and they're more viable. And to give you an example, auto rifles is the category I always like to go back to and look at this. Right now, they're not viable in the Crucible, but let's imagine this was something like a few months ago and they were viable. You'd have three different subcategories in auto rifles, and you can look at their effectiveness according to which subcategory they exist in. So, first of all, of course, you had the really, really high caliber ones that had a very slow rate of fire. That's things like Suras Regime, things such as, say, the old Vanquisher 8, the new Monarchy auto rifle. These are really, really strong weapons. You can go ahead and use these in almost any situation because they are so versatile. Having said that, they are better lended to long-range ones. Now, of course, also there are the mid-range kind of multi-role auto rifles. These are things like the Shingen C, Shingen E, the new Vindicator 9 from New Monarchy is another really good example. Yeah, these weapons, I think, are generally speaking the best in terms of Crucible performance overall, just because they're a bit more consistent. They've got the rate of fire that makes them quite punchy, but also they've got some, decent impact. They're not kind of like Atheon's Epilogues, which have, like, no impact and all rate of fire. Not to mention, you can control these really, really easily. Also, finally, we have, as I mentioned, the Atheon's Epilogues type. High rate of fire, very hard to control, and also no impact. There's only one good thing in there, and it doesn't synergize well with the rest, and these are not usable in Crucible. And this kind of brings me onto the point about weapons that there are some which can be seen in three different kinds of categories. Not just in these kind of high caliber, low caliber, multi-role ones, but also in terms of whether they are, you know, in the meta or not. So there are some which are just not viable whatsoever. So to give you a really good example of that, right now I'd say that weapons that aren't viable in the Crucible are Atheon's Epilogue and Scout Rifles generally, except for maybe things like the Deadshot Luna. Now, the reason I say that is sometimes based on the fact that the weapon just performs really poorly, such as Atheon's Epilogue, but it's also sometimes based on the fact that when you jump into the Crucible, the maps just aren't in your favor. And I'm going to save a lot of that spiel for next episode, because that's kind of the topic I wanted to talk about next episode with regards to Scout Rifles. So yeah. And there are, you know, there's a lot of weapons in this category. The vast majority of weapons in Destiny, I'd say, fall under this one. In the second category, that you have your viable options. You know, most exotics fall within this boundary. So, yeah, sure, Fourth Horseman, Universal Remote, Patience and Time, they're not at the top of the meta. They're not the best things you could ever be using, but they're still very much viable. You can go and take them into a game and do pretty well. I know a lot of people who specialize in playstyles around these weapons. Take Miss 5000 Watts, for example. She used Fourth Horseman at its inception, and that thing was not brilliant, but she got a 52-kill game with that. And I don't mean 52 kills as in she arc-bladed one dude and then, you know, got a million different kills for some reason. Not sure how that glitch ever happened. If you don't know what I'm talking about, I'm going to link that in the description because it's really funny. But when you look at all those weapons, they are absolutely viable. You can use them, you can get kills, and a decent player will easily be able to go positive with them. That's what I mean by viable. So, again, a lot of weapons do fall into this category. Some auto rifles, even with the current nerfs, will still fall into this category. And then you can also look at the final category, which is the things that truly are in the meta. These are your Fellwinter's Lies, your Thorns, your Red Deaths, your Hawkmoons, your Last Words, all sorts of things. So really, you're gonna want to pick these up if you're one of those players that doesn't really have that much of a competitive edge. There are some people like Triple Rec who just have insane gun skill. There are some people like me who have some gun skill, although I say constantly that I have almost none, and have some mind skill. There are some people who have insane mind skill. These are the kind of players who can easily take a weapon and make it viable. But with anyone else who's kind of your borderline average 1.1 KD Crucible player, you should go ahead and consider using one of these weapons if you're really uncomfortable with anything else. Having said that, I always emphasize on this show that you should never, ever, 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 ever let something become your crux, because that is the way that you immediately pigeonhole yourself as a poor Crucible player. For example, people who always use shotguns, or people who only ever use Thorn, instead of trying to experiment with a variety of other weapons, you know? That's kind of problematic. You can see I'm using Thorn in this particular video. That's admittedly because I'm in Trials and I want to have something that gives me information and I want to be on top of the meta, but still, I could improve. I could try using another weapon and maybe switching it up. There are exotics that I could potentially use in my special slot, for example, that might do a little better. Even so, you know, people will run to cover and run for something they recognize when they have an opportunity. Anyway, that's what I really wanted to talk about. Just look at your weapons as your piece of homework, I suppose, for this episode, and tell me, you know, is there something you lean on as a crux? And if that's so, then is it really kind of a bad idea to do that? So let me give you an example. I'm going to call someone out here. Sean, Messer Sean, you hath been called out, for I know that your crux is either an auto rifle, such as your beloved Surus Regime, or your Vex Terrificlast, as you call it. So yeah, stop leaning on that. Start using something else. Give other weapons a try. And when you do, think about the weapons you're using, think about all sorts of different things to do with the weapon. And yeah, tell me, do you think that your playstyle is viable? Do you reckon you should be using something else? Do you reckon that you could use this playstyle, but you need to vary things up? Do you think you need a little bit more gun skill or mind skill? Tell me things about what you do with your particular setup in the comments section below. Anyway, my name is Bife. Per audacia ad astra. I'll see you, Starside.